A new year brings new hope for a family struck by not one, but two tragedies involving sisters. In November, Amber Wilkins almost died when a dump truck allegedly ran a red light and hit her SUV. In 2004, her younger sister Kayla died in a similar crash. Tonight, their brother shares his story of strength and sorrow with KETV NewsWatch 7's Michelle Banjour.
This is Kayla's 15th birthday.
Two sisters together. In a time that seems so long ago for the Wilkins family, the youngest sister, Kayla, is gone. Now 6 years after her death.
When I first heard it was just, I didn't believe that it was happening. It just seemed too crazy to be true.
The other sister, Amber, is recovering from a traumatic brain injury. A dump truck hit the young mother as she drove to work November 5th. Amber was in a coma for days.
For the first 3 days, it was really just waiting to see if she would make it through the hour.
Painful similarities, painful reminders for the oldest of the three siblings.
There's no way this is actually happening again.
In 2004, when Kayla was 15, she died in a car crash. 2 months after Amber's car accident, she's recovering from her brain injury. Ryan focuses on his faith to understand why one sister was taken and another spared.
And now here in this situation, we prayed for Amber to live, and she's going to. And I don't really see that as God not answering prayer in one incident and answering prayer in another incident. I just see that God's will and his vision are greater than mine.
The Wilkins aren't alone. A parent from the ornaments on this Christmas tree in Amber's room at the rehab center. Gifts from friends and strangers who have embraced Amber's recovery.
To feel that kind of love around us has been really uplifting, and it's really strengthened us.
With a new year, another chance. Yeah. This big brother has a New Year's wish for his little sister.
I'm hopeful that in end of 2011, Amber can be close to resuming work again and maybe independent living again. I think those are all real possibilities, like for this next year.
Michelle Banjour, KETV NewsWatch 7.